Good morning, children. Now, today we will start the new topic, that is cyclic hydrocarbon. Now, what is the cyclic hydrocarbon? Before that, I had told you that carbon atom combines with carbon atom itself. That is, carbon links with carbon or combines with carbon to form a long chain. Now, three different types of chains can be formed. That is, carbon atom links with carbon atom, another carbon atom, to form three different types of chain. Now, first chain is straight chain, which you have studied, alkane, alkene, alkyne, in that all it was straight chain. Another is branch chain. Third one is cyclic chain. Now, what is this from this cyclic chain? Cyclic chain is closed chain. Now, from this cyclic chain, cyclic hydrocarbon is formed. Hydrocarbon in which carbon atoms are arranged in the form of rings, closed rings. That is cyclic hydrocarbon. Now, you have two different types of cyclic hydrocarbon, saturated cyclic hydrocarbon and unsaturated cyclic hydrocarbon. Saturated, as the word tells you, you have single covalent bond in this, and unsaturated, you have double covalent bond. You'll be studying only two different types. Only one or two examples you'll be studying. That much is enough. That whatever given in your NCERT textbook, only that much you have to study for cyclic hydrocarbon, not more. Now, saturated cyclic hydrocarbon, one example we'll see for hexane. Okay, hexane, it is called as cyclohexane. Hexane, you know it is having six carbon atoms. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is 1, here 2, 3, 4, 5, and this is 6. Got it? One single bond in all these carbon atoms, closed one. Now, to satisfy for this carbon, two bonds are more left. So, it will combine with two hydrogen. Now, this also will combine with two hydrogen. This again will combine with two hydrogen. Each carbon atom will combine with two hydrogen. Okay. So, now, this is your each. If one is satisfying four valencies, this carbon atom, 1, 2, 3, 4. Check for each. Be sure that each carbon atom, it is satisfying its four valency. Then you count, here it is 6 carbon atoms, C6, and hydrogen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So the formula of cyclohexane is C6H12. Cyclohexane, the name, this is the structural formula, this is the molecular formula. Molecular formula, or you can say chemical formula. Molecular formula, this is structural formula, and this is the name of that. Now, you can see here one more thing. If you say hexene, H-E-X-E-N-E, what is the formula of this, molecular formula of this compound? C6, general formula is C-E-N-H-2-N. So, it will be C6H12. So, you can see one thing. Though it is hexene, it is having the same molecular formula, but the structure is different. Though it is having same molecular formula, when it is straight chain, it is hexene, but when it is having ring arrangement, it is cyclohexane. Okay? Now, this is about cyclohexane. You can make for cyclopentane. Also, heptane, more, but not more is given in your textbook. Now, unsaturated hydrocarbon, the example is benzene, compound benzene. This is also having 6 carbon atoms. So, here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Now, it is having double covalent bond as said. So, in first one, it is having single, then double. Single, then double. Alternate, it will have double covalent bond. Okay, so 3 single and 3 double. And then satisfy its valencies. Here 1, 2, 3, 4. Fourth one with hydrogen. Fourth bond it is forming with hydrogen. Each carbon atom is forming its fourth bond with hydrogen. So you can count C6H 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. C6H6. So this is the molecular formula of benzene. C6H6. This is the structural formula of benzene. And the electron dot structure, I'll show you. You can see it here. I'm just rubbing this for you so that it can be clear. See, you just be careful. It has six. Okay. Now first one single bond, so one pair of electrons. Second one is double bond, so two pairs of electrons. Okay. Then third one single bond, one pair. Here double bond, so two pairs. Wherever there will be one pair of electron, there is single covalent bond. When there is two pairs of electrons, that is double covalent bond. So alternate double, double, double. Okay. And then fourth one with hydrogen. Fourth one with hydrogen. This is here electron dot structure of benzene. Electron dot structure. Got it? This way you can write the electron dot structure. I told you about the structural formula. For this also you can write the electron dot structure everywhere. For each and every it is important. In examination it comes particularly. Either electron dot structure can be asked, or structural formula can be asked, or molecular formula can be asked, or your structure of molecule, which I showed it for ethyne. It's given in the book for each one. You just practice it accordingly. Name, structural formula, condensed structural formula. Then after that, molecular formula. You have electron dot structure and structure of molecule. All these things can be asked separately. Again, I repeat. First one, name of the molecule. Second, this is name of the molecule, cyclohexane. Second, structural formula. Third, molecular formula. For alkane and all, you will be having condensed structural condensed formula also. Okay, like you had condensed formula, you can see there in your book. You can get it here. Electron dot structure, and then the last one is your molecule structure of the molecule. Structure of the molecule. Don't get confused. Structure of the molecule, electron dot structure. These two are little bit similar, because from electron dot only you will be getting the structure of the molecule. Got it? So these all separately are important. Anything can be asked for any of the compounds. These are all very important. You need to prepare it properly for each and every one. Got it? So this is all about your cyclic hydrocarbon. The next we'll be studying about branched hydrocarbons and their naming in the next class. Thank you.